Now our movement, we're part of a worldwide movement. It used to be called religious science, but that became increasingly confusing to folks. And I need to share with you some of the things that we are not. We are not Christian science. We are not Scientology. We've never been any of that. I think another thing is that as you understand this, you realize that we're not a traditional spiritual approach. We're non-traditional, and yet we bring forth new rays of light that I think are very important and valuable in the spiritual landscape. Now, in this regard, please understand that our teaching is called the science of mind and spirit. That's our teaching. Now, we are a part of a movement now called Centers for Spiritual Living. We're also a part of a larger umbrella movement called New Thought, simply New Thought, or New Thought, Ageless Wisdom. Now, our movement is not a heavy-handed, controlling, domineering kind of religion. We're not into that, you know. Too much religion in the past has been toxic, cultivating lots of fear and division. And I think that more and more individuals are waking up to that and sadly enough, opting out of those kinds of thought systems. I actually believe that there are twin sins of religion, if you look at history. The twin sins of religion are absolutism and authoritarianism. Absolutism, the declaration that there's only one teaching or one valid truth, and all others are invalid or inconsequential. Now that kind of absolutism then usually spawns authoritarianism. And that becomes a heavy-handed, controlling church, telling people what to do, what to think, how to live, making their choices for them, and otherwise intentionally manipulating them. And in that regard, then, this kind of authoritarianism has, over history, been the starting point for so much aggression and division and discrimination, violence, and even racism. And so we're really not involved in that whatsoever. We want to be a new answer to those kinds of tendencies. Now, in that regard, science of mind, in this teaching, we don't tell people what to think. How in the world would we ever want to tell a bunch of rebellious people like you what in the world to think? I love that about you, by the way. You're free thinkers. You're self-reliant. We don't tell people what to think. We aspire to help people learn how to think, and to think beyond the old ideas, the old concepts, the old limits in their life. Now, we have no political affiliations or leanings. We don't tell you how to vote. We don't endorse or denounce any candidates or public officials. We don't do that. We leave that to your own guidance in your life. Now, what we do is that occasionally we do speak out about instances of social injustice. Wherever we notice those, wherever we notice things going on that are incongruent with our ultimate vision, and that is oneness revealed. We want to be a part of the evolution of spirituality. Our founder wrote, "The religion of the future will appear when religion gets over its superstition, science gets over its materialism, and philosophy gets over its duality. We are forerunners in a campaign of spiritual freedom, intellectual integrity, and emotional stability in a spiritual world. It is our privilege to take part in a new spiritual renaissance."